IVM.
Hi.
You're
listening
to
IVM
Daily.
Hi, welcome to a brand new episode of IVM Daily. With me in the studio, I have Karthik Mohan.
Hello.
And I am Abbas, and it's just the two of us here because once again, we are bringing you a wrestling roundup, something that none of the other people nobody else in the office is interested in wrestling. It's just the two of us. So it's us again. So today we're talking about one particular pay-per-view or event that happened in WWE this past Sunday. Which is abbreviated as TLC. What does TLC stand for, Karthik?
Tables, ladders, and chairs.
Damn, it's not tender love and caring.
You must definitely watch TLC for that.
Yeah, I thought it was gonna be answer. It's gonna be the event where all wrestlers just come together and they just settle all their differences with tender love and caring. But no, it's in a nutshell, it's a pay-per-view where almost every match has a stipulation. You can either, there are tables matches, chairs matches, ladder matches, and some matches are all three, which are called TLC matches. So we'll quickly run through why this particular pay-per-view was important. So what do you want to start with, Karthik? Overall, okay, let me, before I begin, overall, did you enjoy the event?
I really enjoyed the women's division.
Okay.
As usual.
Like, yeah.
2018 was like the women's division.
Yeah. Year.
And I liked a couple of matches other than women's wrestling.
Mm-hmm.
Namely, I would say the Daniel Bryan and AJ Styles match.
Okay.
And obviously the Seth Rollins versus Dean Ambrose.
Dean Ambrose match,
for the,
yes.
For the Intercontinental title.
Yeah. I think both those rivalries are going pretty well. Like
any rivalry with Shield in it.
That's true.
Yeah,
yes.
They nail it.
Yeah. So very quickly, what about some of the tag team matches? Did you enjoy them? Did you even care about them?
I did like the Bar versus the
New
Usos
Day.
Versus the New Day.
Mm.
Because I pretty much like the New Day. Because whenever they're in the ring,
right,
they never fail to perform. That's what I feel. And Cesaro and
Sheamus is are like, really good. Yeah,
and
that's true.
Usos as a new face, Usos face as in like the new attire, I would say, the new look.
What's their new attire?
Earlier it used to be very colorful.
Earlier they were going with the whole Samoan thing.
The Samoan thing.
Right.
Now they are like the underground hip hop.
Oh really?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I like the swag and all that they carry and all. Yeah.
So Cesaro and Sheamus defeated New Day and
Usos. Yeah.
So they went into the match as the champions, or did they
went as a champion?
Oh, they retained the championship.
Yeah, they retained.
All right. Cool. Then, of course, there was another very curious match, which was Braun Strowman versus Baron Corbin. A TLC match, tables, ladder, anything goes kind of a match. I was kind of interesting because, I mean, it's almost like WWE right now is holding out till giving Braun Strowman the main event at WrestleMania.
Yeah, yeah.
So they're just waiting, who should we give him? And they paired him up with Baron Corbin. Baron Corbin is one of those characters, like, I hate him as a character, but I feel sorry for him for the guy who's playing the character.
Yeah.
Because just to very quickly recap, the thing is, so Sunday TLC happened, and on Monday night Raw, the McMahons came in the ring, and they're blaming everything that's going wrong with the product on Baron Corbin.
Yeah.
And in my head, I'm like, he's a character. You gave him, like, it's not like he's actually doing those things. You gave him this character to mess everything up. And then you actually punish him for it. But anyway, coming back, Braun Strowman defeated Baron Corbin.
With one hand.
These hands.
Want to get this hand. So it was a handicap match.
Yeah, the thing that was on the line on this for this match was, if Baron Corbin loses, he loses the chance to be the general manager of Raw.
Yeah.
Which happened, and he's no longer the general manager of Raw. But yeah, okay match. I mean,
I personally didn't like it.
Yeah, I would have also preferred Braun Strowman to, you know, fight someone, you know, worthy of it. But
where
anyway,
was Brock Lesnar, as usual?
That's the WrestleMania match, right? I think that's what is going to happen. So wait, but Braun Strowman now has won something. He's got a title shot at Royal Rumble.
Yeah.
Which will be against Brock Lesnar.
Yeah.
Okay, which I think there will be an interruption by Corbin, and then
they'll eventually shift it to WrestleMania.
Yeah, moment. I think that's the big match.
And
I
there
see
should
at
be a title change. What
there should think? Be a title change.
There should be a title.
I mean,
title
see
change.
If there's
and that should be a clean match.
Yeah, yeah, of course. If there's no title change, then all this stuff that the McMahons are saying we're going to listen to the fans and all that will be of no use. And also, Braun Strowman now is full on face. He's not even an anti-hero. People cheer for him. And he's full on. Very quickly, other matches that kind of took place. Rey Mysterio and Randy Orton had a chairs match, which Rey Mysterio won.
Yeah, the veterans.
Veterans going at it each other, and decent match.
Yeah.
There was Ronda Rousey, the big Ronda Rousey who we spoke of on the last podcast about wrestling, defeated Nia Jax.
I didn't like the match.
You didn't like the match, but this was clearly punishment for Nia Jax for injuring Becky Lynch.
And you saw the backstage segment. Did you see the backstage segment?
No, I didn't. What happened backstage?
So Becky Lynch attacked Nia Jax.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So okay. She was like, she said something like, "Never use my name again." After the loss.
Okay.
Yeah, that was like the highlight of the show.
Right.
I would say,
Another match: Natalya defeated Ruby Riott. Finn Balor defeated McIntyre. But now let's come to the three big matches.
Yeah.
Bryan versus AJ Styles.
Oh God.
There, I think these two have been going at each other for I think about two three months now.
2-3 months.
Yeah.
When was it last title change? Before the.
Before the Survivor Series, yeah. So about that third or fourth encounter amongst each other. What did you think of the match?
Do you like, I would ask the question, do you like Daniel Bryan as the heel?
I love Daniel Bryan as the heel.
God.
I was really getting sick of the yes movement.
Yeah.
Because, like he peaked with that. And then he got injured. And then he was out for so long. And then him as a GM, I kind of got... But then when he was given the green light to wrestle again, I really wanted something new from this character because he was getting very repetitive. He wasn't doing anything interesting after coming back from the injury.
Yeah.
So this heel turn is amazing. I think I really love Daniel Bryan as the heel.
Same,
it's just the fact that this guy who made audiences go yes, yes, yes can now can get booed. It's amazing, I think.
It's shame now.
Yeah.
It's shame. It's not even no.
It's shame.
Yeah.
Yeah, I love
no chant, right?
He did when he was tag team partner with
the Hell
Kane.
No, yeah.
Team
Hell No.
Team Hell No, yes.
Team Hell No, yeah.
Yeah, so I love Daniel Bryan, heel Daniel Bryan. And I love champion heel Daniel Bryan. Yeah.
And I love the feud. AJ Styles versus Daniel Bryan.
You think they'll go head to head at WrestleMania? I have a feeling they might add Miz to the mix and do a triple threat at
and
WrestleMania.
And Miz as a face.
Miz as a face, yeah.
So I didn't see the whole SmackDown, but Miz and
Shane McMahon.
Mandy Rose won the
mixed match.
The mixed match, yeah.
Okay. So the thing is with Miz, if they ever do this WrestleMania match, if it's AJ Styles. Daniel Bryan and Miz, you have face AJ Styles, heel Daniel Bryan, and then we can have Miz, like we can keep guessing which side he's gonna go on. That'll be interesting.
And people love Miz and Randy Orton as heels. Like,
that's true.
They can get booed like just by entering.
That's
and Chris
true.
Jericho for sure.
Of course.
Yeah.
So cool match. Daniel Bryan won via roll up.
Yeah.
Not a quote unquote clean victory, but he's the champion for now. Dean Ambrose versus Seth Rollins.
Always in for
singles match for the Intercontinental Champion, and Intercontinental Champion changed hands. Dean Ambrose is the new Intercontinental Champion. I actually didn't expect this. Did you expect
this? It was a clean match.
It was a clean match. He won clean despite being a heel.
And I like the way WWE is
building
for WrestleMania, I would say.
Sure.
Yeah, I guess this would be going to WrestleMania for sure. This is going to WrestleMania for sure.
I like heel Dean Ambrose as well.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The bulk Dean Ambrose.
Also, I think this is a great way to build up Seth Rollins also because by the time if they do this at WrestleMania, by that time, the heat will be so much. Like the brothers who are now torn apart, going at each other. That's great storytelling.
And it was necessary for the title as well.
That's true. Yeah. Intercontinental title for last few years hasn't been getting the prestige it deserves.
Yeah.
But now with these two, it's amazing. So Ambrose wins clean. You have anything else to say about this match?
There was a moment when the shield bump.
Yeah, you
the
told
shield,
me about this.
Yeah, the shield fist bump. Like Dean Ambrose was getting like bashed, and after that, Dean Ambrose was like, "Let's do a fist bump."
Yeah,
and then Seth Rollins was like, "I would go for that." Then yeah. After that, like, okay, I'll hit him. I'll hit him now. It's not gonna happen. So that was a cool moment. Yeah.
Right. Finally, the main event, again, a women's match main eventing a WWE pay-per-view. Becky Lynch and Charlotte Flair, who were scheduled to go one-on-one, but then
Asuka
was added to the mix. So it was a triple threat match, a ladder match,
TLC
match. Yeah, not a ladder match, I stand corrected.
Yeah.
Becky Lynch versus Charlotte versus Asuka. Amazing match. I saw highlights of this. Once
amazing
again, I mean, Charlotte and Becky Lynch and even Asuka three of the best athletes in all of WWE right now.
The
first ever women's TLC match.
Yeah.
And lived up to the hype.
Actually, like, I loved the match and the brutality in it.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Like,
yeah,
you can never imagine you can never imagine in WWE at least.
Yeah.
A women's match getting, like, so brutal.
True.
Yeah. With the, I don't know, like, it's amazing. And with Ronda.
Yeah, I was coming to that.
Yeah. How can you miss that? Yeah.
So, did you like the ending? So, let me tell you what happened at the end, finally.
Yeah.
There was an interference by Ronda Rousey.
Yeah.
Ronda Rousey comes, knocks out Becky Lynch.
Knocks out Becky Lynch and Charlotte Flair while they were on the ladder.
Right. Yeah. Which leaves Asuka as the last woman standing. Asuka takes the ladder, climbs up the ladder, grabs the belt, and Asuka now is the new SmackDown Women's Champion. Now, my only problem with this is, like, it almost makes it look like Asuka got away with it. Like, she didn't really beat her competition. She just got lucky because Ronda Rousey came down and won it.
Wasn't looking deserving.
Yeah.
Though Asuka is deserving, though.
That's true, exactly. And usually when WWE gives someone a win like this, then they lose the title very soon after.
Yeah.
So, this kind of feels like Asuka right now is like the placeholder champion till they get to a really WrestleMania's level of event and then they really put the women's champion. But I am actually not complaining. I actually was not expecting this end.
Yeah. So, and what do you think? Like, what would be the future of the women's division? SmackDown
it's
women's
very
division
interesting.
Or like the women's division in general?
Yeah, it's very interesting because, again, Ronda Rousey, Raw, Charlotte and Becky Lynch SmackDown, Asuka SmackDown. I think they'll build up till WrestleMania to do a Raw versus SmackDown thing.
Yeah.
So it's very interesting.
It's interesting, yeah.
It's interesting
because
they're
building it up for WrestleMania.
Exactly, yeah.
Because there's only like one or two pay-per-views left.
That's true.
Yeah. So,
but on the Raw side, so who do you have? Ronda's the champion. You have Nia Jax.
Yeah.
You have Natalya.
Then Sasha Banks, Bailey.
Sasha Banks and Bailey, aren't they a tag team now?
So they on Raw they had a gauntlet match.
Oh,
and
the next
Sasha
night.
Lost the match to Natalya.
I see. Okay, so Natalya and Ronda will at some point fight for the championship.
The next week itself.
The next week on Raw. Oh, okay, that's interesting. Yeah, there's some. I think I don't know. The big match, of course, will be. I mean, in my eyes, it's Ronda versus Becky.
And they'll main event.
They'll main event the thing.
Yeah.
So, I don't know, Charlotte and Asuka somehow they have to.
Would that be a triple threat match?
I hope not. I really want to see Ronda versus Becky.
Becky, one-on-one.
Yeah, one-on-one. Mm. Without interference, without anything. I just want to see them go at it.
Yeah, same here.
Yeah, that would be a great match.
Even Charlotte versus Ronda would be great.
Yeah, but I'd rather watch Becky. Like we said, like this is Becky's moment, right? Like, she has to headline this year's next year's WrestleMania.
And they have a movie with Becky as a bad person, I guess. Like,
really? They're doing a movie on Paige.
So I guess it has to do with the movie that's coming up, like the Marine 6 movie.
Yeah.
In which Becky would be playing the antagonist opposite Miz.
So you're saying that's why she lost?
No, that's the reason. They're playing. Becky's playing the heel, I would say.
But she's not really the heel, right? I mean, the crowd is behind her. She is getting the best, most amazing reactions. She's in no way a heel. In a Becky versus. That's why I want to see a Becky versus Ronda match. Ronda, again, is
Ronda is like a baby face.
She's right a baby now. Face, but but that's what I'm very curious about, who the audience will be behind in a Becky versus Ronda match. Because the next night after TLC, Ronda also kind of, I mean, Ronda Rousey actually coming and beating up Becky and Charlotte is kind of like a heel thing to do. Yeah. It's not a very babyface thing to do.
But she's the baddest bitch on the planet.
Exactly. But that's what both Becky and Ronda are kind of anti-heroes.
Yeah.
So it'll be really fun to see if they go one-on-one who the crowd will be behind. I think they'll be behind Becky a little bit more. It's so funny.
I want Becky to win.
Like, bichari, Asuka won the championship and we're not talking about her at all. But yeah, overall fun match, fun event. I think the last two matches kind of made up for the lackluster
last three matches
yeah. for the lackluster mid division. I think did. I feel bad for Finn Balor. Like I feel like Finn Balor should be
when
like he had a match with Drew McIntyre yeah. and I don't
both
know.
Both are doing amazing.
Yeah. I don't know. I hope
they're
Finn
pushing
Balor.
Drew McIntyre for like
that's true.
For sure.
Yeah,
and yeah, he would be doing a great match. He would be having a great match eventually in WrestleMania.
I hope so. I hope
there should be a triple threat match: Finn Balor,
Drew McIntyre, and Dolph Ziggler. It'll still be a mid card match. Hmm. What'll be on the line?
Yeah.
Anyway, so yeah, a fun event, a TLC, and the SmackDown and Raw that followed were also not bad. Do write into us if you have thoughts about wrestling, you want us to discuss more WWE stuff. Do let us know. You can reach out to me at Abbas Momin on Twitter. Where can one reach you, Karthik?
I am at Grow Up Mohan. On Instagram and Twitter.
Nice. You can reach out to IVM Podcasts on social media. We are at IVM Podcasts on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. Until the next time, we shall see you again. Till then, bye-bye.
Bye.
Advertising is dead. Yep, you heard me right. Advertising is dead. We're all in the content business now. Let's not call it news, TV, radio, etc., etc. It's all content, and we're in the middle of this weirdly exciting phase where all the borders and lines that have been drawn over decades has been swept away by this lovely thing called the internet. We're a show where we don't dwell on just the stuff that is now, but rather the wider stuff about advertising, media, content, and the whole goddamn circus surrounding it. Tune in every Tuesday for our weekly unboxing of the mystery box we used to call advertising. I'm Varun Dugirala, co-founder and content chief at The Glitch, and this is my new podcast, Advertising is Dead.
How aware do you think you are of your laws and rights? Do you look up to laws when you are caught up in situations? Do you know what your rights are when you're stuck somewhere bad? Well, here's a show that can help you move an inch closer to being aware of what your rights are. Tune in to Know Your Kanoon with me, Amar Rana. This is a podcast meant to answer all your law-related queries. Catch Know Your Kanoon every week on the IVM website or the app or anywhere you get your podcast from.